All right, we're gonna continue our hitting of fours. We've been working a lot on timing and spacing and just getting a good high reach swing. Now today we're actually gonna work on spiking angle on the four and then line on the four. So we set the AccuSpike so that it positions us to hit area five, the 5-4 seam. So if we do it correctly, we're gonna open up, rotate and point slightly away to the right to hit that angle. All right, before we go into hitting fours off the live set, we always try to get a couple of warm-up sets to make sure we're setting consistently so we can actually work on some of the accuracy arm swing things and some defense too. Thank you. All right, now we're gonna work on hitting angle. So that foam roller there is gonna be the libero. So we're gonna work on hitting to the right of that. And that's what we worked on with the AccuSpike. I'm making a documentary called The Rise of Kai about that guy. Don't tell him. So I'm trying to hit to the right of the barrel. I keep hitting at it because the ball is in the center of my body. I'm trying to go away. I got to open up and get my left foot further forward so I can get on my right shoulder and hit sharper on the angle. the adjustment I made was I wasn't getting around the ball. The ball was still kind of in front of my left shoulder. So I think I was starting my hitting approach too far away. So I started my approach a little closer forward, which makes it easier to get around the ball. So the ball is coming at me here, and now I can change direction. It worked. First show, we're gonna do standing floats as part of our passing warm up. Last time we did serve receive from serving aerial 1-1 cross court. Then we're gonna do cross court on the other side, serving from 5-5. So another longest distance on the court, just a different passing angle because the target's now gonna be on the right side. So my focus is the same thing as last week, just making sure I move my feet and get good spacing. Try to get my feet behind the ball just like I did for serving that 1-1. All right, now we're gonna pass jump floats. Just the same thing, but higher velocity. One thing I did not do is I didn't start closer up. So when you're passing from 5-5, it's a longer distance. So you actually need to scoot up more than if you were passing from area 6 or area 1.
Come on.
All right, we're gonna go straight into jump serving and passing jump serves. So, but this time serving area from area five and then hitting straight ahead. And we'll see how it goes. All right, we got 15 minutes left and fatigue is starting to build up, especially when we do a 2-hour practice. So one thing we're gonna try today is to do some two balls. Those are really fun to try to bounce. So when we're fatigued, we're still trying to elicit like a max jump response in our fatigue state. So we're gonna see how that goes.